If the terms rapamycin, mTOR, and autophagy aren't familiar to you already, hang on, this before you tune us out, this has got some practical implications if you want to live a long, healthy life. In fact, what I'm doing, this is part three in a series on the book Lifespan by David Sinclair. I had several requests from viewers like John Tocho, who asked me to review this, and I've had a blast. It's a long book. It covers, it's encyclopedic in length in terms of covering the major topics in longevity. One of the reasons I'm enjoying it so much is I've done videos on most of these topics. For example, rapamycin. Rapamycin was discovered on the island of Rapa Nui. Most of us don't remember Rapa Nui, but you do remember Easter Islands. It's the islands that have the hundreds of statues of stone faces. Rapamycin is also known as sirolimus. The biochemists classify it as a macrolide. You may not remember that, but if you've had involvement with medicine, you know that they are macrolide antibiotics. It's already being used as an immunosuppressant. It's used in stent coatings as well as kidney transplants. It comes from a bug that was found, a bacterium, that was found on the island of Rapa Nui and hasn't been found, wasn't found anywhere else. Streptomyces hygroscopicus. That's Streptomyces hygroscopicus. Don't get too wrapped up in that. No need. It inhibits mTOR. Remember what mTOR stands for? Mammalian target of rapamycin. And you may or may not remember, I've done several videos on this fellow. His name is David Sabatini. He's right next door to David Sinclair at Harvard. Sabatini's over at MIT. He's the one that discovered mTOR, and there's been a huge amount of research growing out of that. Now, why is that? mTOR has a lot to do with controlling catabolism versus anabolism. And catabolism is autophagy. Anabolism is building up, growing. And you see things like anabolic steroids involved with that. So does that help you maybe connect the dots on why men tend to have inflammation and cardiovascular disease and positive calcium scores earlier than women? So there's been a lot of work in that area. I also did a separate video on autophagy. This was from a recent New England Journal article, which was just going into the depths of the mechanisms around autophagy. You may remember autophagy is where the cell is doing recycling. So let's get deep in that for just a second. First, you have initiation using a phagophore, which phago just means to eat. We're going to hold off on that for a second to look at how this phagophore is growing around this dead organelle. And that organelle it's like an organ in the body, except it's within the cell. So it's a very tiny component. If you look more deeply, you can recognize this is a dead mitochondria that this vesicle is wrapping around. As it continues to wrap around it, it closes up, and that, then it's called autophagosome. Autophagosome. Auto meaning self, phago meaning eating, and some meaning body. It's a recycling body that's within the cell, the cytoplasm of the cell, which is basically the soup within the cell wall, and that's a mature autophagosome. Those then combine with what's called a lysosome. Lyso means to split, and again, zome means body. So you've got these enzymes within the lysosomes. They combine with the autophagosome to form an autolysosome. A lot of Greek words or Latin words you really don't need to know about, but the process itself, I think, is very, very helpful. And then what happens is that these enzymes from the lysosome dissolve the old dead tissue, in this case an old dead mitochondrion, then use that for energy and building blocks for the future, for other new cell parts. Now, when we've got things like insulin, too much insulin, or insulin-like growth factor, as you see here up at the top, you get too much, those tend to stop this autophagy process. So if you look at this slide is basically to help us connect the dots with other things that you may have heard of, like insulin, like IGF, insulin-like growth factor, AMPK. You may remember AMPK helps drive some of these processes, autophagy versus anabolic processes. AMPK, by the way, you may remember, and Sinclair mentions in the book, AMPK is stimulated by metformin. Sinclair, by the way, thinks that that is the total longevity mechanism for metformin. We'll talk about metformin and longevity as he did, but we'll do it in another video on this series. Remember concepts of energy depletion and starvation or fasting? Again, those help drive this autophagy process. Remember rapamycin? Rapamycin, again, helps direct this process. So again, hopefully this helps helps you connect some dots that you may have heard in some other videos. And thank you for your interest.
So I'm very excited to announce we now have a membership page. Now, what is that? That's the one place where you can go and access all of our digital products. It starts off with a few free things, like a lot of infographics, which help you understand the basics of insulin resistance, cardiovascular inflammation, and other key concepts on how to prevent heart attack and stroke. The next free item is the intro and first chapter of the book that we're writing on plaque. The standards of medicine just aren't doing very well right now in terms of the number one killer and disabler, plaque. We don't do a good job of measuring it. We don't do a good job of monitoring it. And there are better ways. So that's what this book is all about. Again, go in and get a look at the intro and the first chapter. And if you've purchased the cardiovascular inflammation and IR courses, thank you so much for doing that. You purchased those at a time before we had them totally cleaned up, and we've cleaned them up now. And they're available for you right there on the membership page. Hit the link below, register, and go in and take a look. Look forward to seeing you there. Thank you.